I have a small task for you. I want you to think about your favorite animal and the type of environment it lives in. For example, if you like polar bears, then you'd say that they live in the Arctic. Or if you like kangaroos, then you'd probably say that they live in the woodlands or the grasslands. Our favorite animals often lead us to imagine the environment they inhabit and how they interact with it. Now, why did I ask you to do that? Well, you see, understanding the environment an animal lives in and how they interact with it is fundamental to ecology. Through ecology, we can unravel the relationship between a species and their environment. Hi there, my name is Liz, and I'm a biologist at Temple University. Welcome to the topic page for ecology here on Fun Science Support. We have different resources to help you learn or teach about what ecology is and why it's so important. To start off, we have a few readings, poems, and writing prompts that dive into the different classification levels of ecology, starting from an individual all the way up to a biosphere. We also discuss the different types of ecosystem services, such as provisioning services and regulating services. From there, we provided two videos from Fun Science Demos, our main YouTube channel. These videos are quite interesting in that they explain how fish adapt to their environment, as well as what a wetlands habitat is and what organisms can be found in it. There are also three interactive simulations on the page. The first is a simulation explaining the dynamics of a predator-prey relationship. You can alter several aspects of the ecosystem, such as the amount of prey or the amount of space they have, to see the effect it has on the prey's population size. The second simulation lets you view the entire globe to see what kind of biomes there are all over the world. And the final simulation focuses on animals with two vastly different lifestyles, that being an elephant and a mouse. It discusses how changing things, like the amount of space or a number of offspring, will greatly affect the number of animals in that ecosystem. And that's all I have. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, Fun Science Support makes it so easy to bring science into your classroom.